Okay, we're putting in some floating islands for the city of Cape Coral.
Yeah, check it out. These floating islands are Beemats, and they're supposed to keep algae out of the canals. The wetlands are covered with aquatic plants that will suck up extra nutrients through the plants. ABC 7's Jessica Babb is getting us more on how the new tools could be a game changer for our waterways.
The city of Cape Coral says it's another tool in the toolbox to help fight algal blooms. They put plants like these onto mats like that to suck up extra nutrients from the waterways.
It is simple, really.
A simple solution.
It's not rocket science.
To a persistent problem.
I'm thrilled.
This is the sound of Beemats going into the pond at Reflections Park.
The only way to get dissolved nutrients out of water, stormwater or reclaimed city water, is through some kind of plant.
They put aquatic plants in the mats to make sure this stuff stays out.
The roots go through the holes in the pots and they grow, they take up nutrients and compete with the algae, so no nutrients left for them.
Eventually, they'll be harvested, trimming back the growth and adding new plants to get rid of some of the nutrients.
It's not like a magic bullet. You have to have something that's going to pull those nutrients out. We have an overabundance of nutrients.
So how well do they work?
Typically, we take out 3 to 5 grams of nitrogen per square meter of mats.
Steve Beeman, a marine biologist with Beemats, says that's a lot.
And it's really kind of a good positive step, I think, for the city.
And it's a pretty cheap one. For 5 locations, it's costing the city close to $65,000.
And they look pretty natural once they're in. Ducks and things will come and nest on them, so they're providing habitat for wildlife as well. But I think it's a pretty cool project.
I look at all these canals and I think, wow, we have a lot of work here.
In Cape Coral, Jessica Babb, ABC 7.